Hello, good morning everyone. Welcome to this series of videos about entry signals. On the two charts that we can see, on the left the crude oil and on the right Nasdaq, we are using signals using the stochastics. The difference between the left side and the right side is that on the left we only use the key line. When the key line is going from the overbought or going from the overbought, we have a signal. On this example, we are using the reversal indicator. As we can see, it has the stochastic settings, but also has filters, like for example the slope of a moving average, on this example 150, which is the blue line. This is the reason why we don't have long signals on the left part of the chart. This is a short signal because the slope is to the downside. On this part we have an upside slope, so we don't get this or these other short signals because we are filtering longs. But we get this one, which is coming from oversold. So we have reversal signals in favor with the trend. On the right side, we use a crossover between the key line and the D line. That cross must happen on the overbought or on the oversold area. Let's see some examples for today. On the reversal today we had three signals. The first one, a short, had a possible fill. That arrows means that we had a possible fill, and then we had a long reversal with a fill, and another long reversal without a fill. The fill happens when the bar with the reversal signal has also a retracement of at least 3 ticks. The entry happens 3 ticks from the extreme of the signal bar. On this case we have a reversal, but we don't have an entry fill. Let's see this on real time with Market Replay. Let's go to 11. We enable long and short on markers. Markers is currently configured to trade cyan arrows and red arrows. The arrows only are painted when we have an entry fill, so not only a reversal signal but also a reversal and a retracement big enough. The red line is the stochastics. It must go below overbought, oversold. Here we are on oversold, so we have a possible reversal, and also this horizontal line is a possible entry. This is the place to place a buy stop if you want to enter manually. When the bar closes, if the reversal is confirmed, it is painted in light color, like now. So now we have a confirmed reversal, but not yet an entry. To get an entry, we need the price to touch the horizontal line, which is placed 3 ticks over the signal bar. We have a fill on the byte stop and also a target. And after this we have the second long signal. We have a confirmed reversal, but the entry line is not touched, so we don't have an entry fill. Now let's see the same setup on Nasdaq, but using the other approach.
Target filled. Order, target, order, order filled. Order filled. Target filled. Order, target filled. Or target filled. Order filled. Target filled.
On this configuration, the detection of a signal produces also an entry. There is no entry method like on reversal. When we have a signal, we have an entry. And the signals happens when we have a cross between the key line and the D line. When the key line crosses the D line coming from overboard, then we have a short signal. On this example, we don't have a signal because the key line is not coming from the overboard. The last point was below the overboard. Let's see a buy signal. Here, there we have a cross above the D line coming from the oversold area. So we have a buy. Okay, thank you everyone. If you have any question, please post below this video. Bye bye.